So tonight, Blitzkrieg. We learned last week from David DeYoung, really just a riveting photographic journey of the veterans of World War I. And he talked to us briefly about the Peace of Versailles and what led to Munich. So we're going to kind of pick up from there and kind of retread some old ground. But the world at war once again. Understand in the minds of not just Adolf Hitler, but many Germans, that indeed they were the criminals at Versailles. It was Versailles that did this to Germany. Not Germany to Germany, Versailles did this to Germany. It was a winner's justice. It was a victor's justice that was very unjust. So Germany had lots of pent-up emotion that took place from really the minute the armistice took place after World War I. Poland, created on German soil. And Poland has been that country that has been on and off the map during this 20th century. And it was put right on German territory. German army was limited to 100,000 troops, a very small army, nowhere near sufficient to defend itself. This, again, one of the requirements of the Treaty of Versailles. And $30 billion in reparations. We think of how much $30 billion is in 2013 dollars. It's a staggering amount. In 1919, it was really an insurmountable, almost a number of no relevance because it was so high. So as we learned last week, the failed peace at Versailles led to the very next generation fighting the same battle. Wonderful pictures of German marks being burned because that was really the most valuable use for them. Hyperinflation resulted in an economy in ruins, and thus we've got just stacks of money being burned because the only value was for a heating source. This is somewhat of a map of Germany after 1914. We see how Germany is at its greatest, it's retracted some. We see Czechoslovakia, Austria, look at West Prussia, particularly the land here in the yellow. This is what's going to be of immediate concern over the next few generations. And really, that's going to be the reclaiming of Greater Germany. And that'll be number one on the mind of not just Adolf Hitler. Remember, this is a man that motivated and moved an entire generation. When I think of Blitzkrieg, I think of the incredible economic miracle of Germany in the 1930s. Remember, the 1930s was a global depression. We know exactly what the United States was immersed in, as were virtually all capitalist countries. Yet Germany led their way out of this depression far sooner than any of the countries in the West. This, to me, is the real blitzkrieg of Germany, was their economic miracle. They did this through a few practices. First and foremost was the mandatory conscription. What that did, of course, was to lower unemployment and build a trained military for future use. Just like in the United States, we saw massive government investments, but this was really investing in a variety of public works programs, and particularly infrastructure that we know as the Autobahn. And when you examine the German Autobahn, the highway system was east to west. And it was built for a variety of reasons, but to move troops along there. As the public works kept growing and growing, building their infrastructure. The United States had a similar program here under President Roosevelt, looking to recover from the Depression. But remember, it took us really right up until 1940. Deficit spending, massive deficit spending, government intervention in the economy, drawing huge deficits, putting money back. And this change in economics really is what brought the German miracle. Their economy led really Europe out of the Depression, and it was just the miracle that allowed the National Socialist Party to come to the forefront. Restoring Greater Germany. This was the national security program. This is what Germany was looking to accomplish in the 1930s, to reunite the once-lost empire. And so you can see over the 3-4 year period of post-1936 that you've got a series of military adventures where Germany is reuniting the greater Germany. And this was really, the seeds of this was laid with the economic reconstruction of the country. Also remember how Adolf Hitler came to power. Through elections, we tend to forget that. This was a man elected to his position. And we can carp about the idea that it was a third-party election, and we can look at the, perhaps, election irregularities, and they would probably mirror many of the elections that we're all used to, especially those of you from Chicago. But the point is that this was a man who was democratically elected, and the National Socialist Party offered a very real alternative at a time when capitalism seemed to be failing the world. And probably no bigger stage was that played out on than the 1936 Olympics. Interesting point of history, how the 36 Olympics, of course, were scheduled in Berlin. Anybody know where the 1940 Olympics were scheduled? They were ultimately canceled? In Tokyo. Yeah. I guess things just happen sometimes, perhaps for a reason. So understanding that the goal of Germany, and I think it's important to put a humanistic face on Germany. It's all too easy, particularly for young people, of they don't know what Adolf Hitler is, they just know it's some evil guy take over the world. Well, that's simple, and if you want a simple answer, that's probably as good as any. But I think most of us understand that simple answers are rarely the real answers in life. But this was the goal of Germany, to reunite the lost territories.